Hello all, thanks for joining me for my 7 useful tips for CNC plasma cutting tables. My background ranges from running a plasma cam when I first started off to selling multiple CNC tables, getting into water jet tables, and then into fiber laser tables. I've been doing this for about 20 years, and my experience runs from the off-road fabrication business all the way into rockets and the aerospace business. So the tip number one that I'd like to get into is drilling the plasma cut holes. We all know that the cutting of holes with the plasma cutter does not come out cleanly in most cases, and that either you're faced with two options, either drilling the hole out or putting the hole in that is oversized. A lot of people that I see try to drill on these holes out go in from the same direction that the plasma cutter was cutting, and really that's not the right way to do it. You will chew up drill bits and the edges of the drill bits really quickly. The way to do it is simply turn the piece upside down, and the drill bit does not chip the corners of the drill bit, and it goes straight through really easily. Tips number two, easy dross removal. I found that on thicker pieces, the dross is pretty heavy, and a lot of times you can just knock it off with a hammer. But I've used in the past a chipping hammer or chipping chisel, and this makes easy removal of dross in a method that takes a little time and leaves a pretty nice finish, where if you took a grinder and started grinding through that dross, it would take you a much longer time because the dross is on the part just enough to you have to grind all the way through it and it doesn't chip off. Also check out a video I have on my channel using a wood belt sander to remove dross easily. This is a great time saving system. Links down in the description. Tip number three is bending slots. A lot of times I use these slots into a part where I need an easy bend, and that just makes it easy to either put in the vise and bend to the direction you need it if it doesn't need to be very strong, and or you can actually weld these slots together after you've bent the part. Another tip for bending is I like to put these about 1/8 inch diameter holes in the edge of a part to allow you to line up into a press break for easy bending, and also these holes release a relief for stress so you don't get any cracking on the edges of the bend. Tip four for the lead ins and lead outs. I like to have my lead in and lead out to a point where it is going to go in a corner. That way you don't have any little pieces of material left from the piercing process. And also in the holes, I like to lead in and lead out from one point. I use sheet cam a lot, so this allows you to do either perpendicular or arc lead ins and lead outs. Also with the piercing, I do not use a pierce delay, and then I try to pierce a little higher than my cut height for the torch height control, and I just put my bleed ins long enough that as soon as the plasma cutter starts, the machine starts moving, and then you have less dross that gets built up and onto the tip of the plasma cutter. Tip five, keep your air dry. We all have seen the green flame of death. This usually happens when moisture gets into your plasma cutter and the moisture is actually interfering with the plasma arc itself. You want a clean blue flame coming out of that. I've used the Harbor Freight refrigerated air dryer for over 10 years now. Knock on wood, it hasn't failed me yet, and it keeps the air really dry, and this saves a lot of money on consumables. tip 6 diamond plate. It's so interesting to me how manufacturers even advertise for this, you know, showing the diamond plate facing up. And yes, a torch high control could keep up with the variations of the diamond plate thread, but it to get that tuning right, it kind of takes some finessing and doesn't always happen successfully. So the easiest way to deal with diamond plate is literally just, you know, put it upside down and you invert your drawing in the in your CAD if it needs to be inverted, and you get easy cuts, and then when it comes off the table, it's straightforward, and the torch high control has no issues whatsoever with running with that the flat side of the plate. And my tip 7 is slots. The neatest thing that I've always found that when I first been able to use a CNC plasma table is that you can use slots. It's easy to put slots in things, and this makes it so much easier from a design perspective. You're making a bracket and such, where you can have one circular hole that is your locating hole, and then use slots everywhere else, and that lets you not have to be exactly precise in your bracket design, and it makes life so much easier when you're trying to make a bracket or a mounting hole, you know, base plate or something that has to match up to pre-existing holes. Thanks for joining me, and I really appreciate it. Subscribe for more, and don't forget to check out my channel that has me putting a CNC fiber laser onto a plasma table. Thanks.